everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to talk about the static and dynamic linking, and the means of static and dynamic linking is that when you are ready with your big projects, even small projects, and you want send it in another place without sending all those included file in the project, and you are going to use a .lib file and .dll file. In .lib you can the program is gather all those programs and information in one file, and you can all those programs are available. And in DLL, when you make a DLL file, all those information are gathered, but they cannot be reached. And you make a .exe, an executable file. Okay, to start, we are going under start program lsc, and I am going to new under file new project, and I am going to use 64 bytes static, and I am going to call it make a directory in my directory and call it static and I am going to use 64 bits, and I am going to call it static as well, and I am going to put it inside static and press OK. And under file new, new C file, I need that one, and I save it as static as well, but it is C source file, and I am going to put inside that one, and I am going to use new resource, and I am going to right click on nameless import. I am going to one, I'm using all files, and I am selecting the C source file, and it appear here. Double click on it, and it is the context of all those programs we went through, and it is okay. But I am going to under project, under resource, I am going to add version, and it stands when you have created which file size and everything, and I am going to save the resource file as static as well. And it is going to put under our directory. Now everything is okay, and I am going to see inside my everything is here. The sea source, the static, and the resource, all of them are here. Okay? I'm going back and make a new directory. My DLL, I call it. Okay. Now I am going to exit that project and I'm going under new file, new project, and I am selecting the dynamic library, and I'm going to use my DLL, and it's going automatically put in my DLL directory, and I am going to use a new, I'm going to save it as my DLL as C source, and it's going to add to my DLL file, and I am going under project or under here new resource and right click on it, import. Now I'm going to import the V1 and select it, and everything is here. Everything is here. And I am going to use under resource, I am going to use under project, no? Under resource, new resource. Under resource, it should happen up here. Version, and the version show when you have created your my DLL, and I am going to save it to as my DLL resource file, and it's going to add here everything. Is here, I am going to save the project. I am going to save or big my DLL.dll, and it is ready, and I am going to see in my DLL. It is C resource, and it is the project, and it is that one. That one is your file. That one
suspicious
is your
item
file.
Has been detected.
But my system put it away, delete it automatically, because it is it has some codes, so doesn't. Accept with my. Now I'm going to delete that one. Now I'm going to select static again. Now I'm going to select the project. Okay. Okay. And I'm going to under project big delete. And it is okay. And it my system put away because it has it has few things that it doesn't accept in my system. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial, which is the graphical starting of your graphical user interface.